Yeah, good morning. In this session now I am going to discuss about how we are writing a program for energy and power signals. Before writing the program, that how we are writing the program for that energy signal. A energy signal is said to be the, what is the theory part I already explained in what is energy signal? If it is energy, if a signal is said to be the energy signal, we have to find that energy as well as power. Okay, na? If energy is finite and power is zero, then the signal is said to be the energy signal. When we have to find that signal, power signal, here power signal, if we can, the given signal is the power signal or not, we have to check either that we have to check that energy as well as power. A power signal is a signal. Here the average power of the signal is finite. If average power of the signal is finite and energy of the signal is infinite, then the signal is said to be the, that is power signal. Okay, na? That signals, now I am writing a program here. Okay, na? First now I am writing the program for energy signal, energy of a signal. Here this is CLC, that means CLC clearing of that previous clearing of our window purpose, we are using clearing all clearing purpose, we are using the CLC. Now here now I am creating a one vector, create a vector n of 51 samples. One vector, now I am creating n of, n means that is at 51 samples. What is the n? For that purpose, n is equal 0 to 50 with that increment of 1. With that increment of 1, now I am taking from 0 to 50, that means 51 samples. Okay, na? Now I am creating one vector. Already created. Create that signal. What is the signal? Here, energy. Now I am finding the signal is energy. Energy, what is the formula? Summation of n is equal minus infinity to infinite mod of x of n whole square. Mod of x of n whole square. Okay, na? Now for that purpose, now I am creating one signal, that is x of n is equal 1 by 2 to the power of n into u of n. 1 by 2 to the power of this cap, it indicates this power of n into u of n. U of n is the unit step signal. Here that is 1 by 2 to the power of 1 by 2 into power of n, that is signal. X signal is created. Now plot of two dimensional to three dimensional n comma x. N means what? That n means number of the samples in time axis. This x means, that is that 1 by 2 to the power of n means, that is in amplitude, that is the y axis. Okay, na? Here to get that MATLAB axis, MATLAB MTLB, MTLB underscore axis. Here the x axis, the limits are from 0 to 25 and y axis are the amplitude of y axis is 0 to 1. 0 to 1. MTLB underscore axis, MATLAB, that is the particular axis. Okay, na? X axis is, these two are indicates for that x axis, these two are indicates for the y axis. Okay, na? Display the calculated energy of the signal. Now when we are typing this, now the calculated, whatever the energy of the signal is displayed. Now calculate the energy of the signal purpose. Sum of, our formula is sum of absolute value of x to the power of x to the power of square. Absolute value of mod of x of square. That is our formula. To get that output here, our, now I am using the syntax, is equal sum of absolute value of x dot of cap, this is the power. Now we have to display the particular, display the theoretical energy of the signal. Whatever the theoretical value of the signal is, it is displayed. The theoretical value is, now that is here 4/3, it is displayed. Okay, na? This is the program we are using for to generate the energy of the signal. After writing the program, click on here save and execute, then we will get graph. What is this? This is my graph. Okay, na? These are my graph. In this x-axis is from 0 to 1 and y-axis is from 0 to 25. That means 25 axis for the indication of axis. Okay, this is graph for energy signal. Now same as it is, now I am writing the program for next energy signal. Next one is, that is power signal. Okay, na? Power signal. This is the program for to get that power signal. Power n is equal to 2. The value of n, the number of the samples, that is equal to 2. The time axis from minus 2 to 2 with that increment of 0.001. Okay, now I am generating one signal, that is the cos signal. X is equal to cos of 2 pi ft formula whole square. Cos of 2 pi ft whole square. Now I am generating here one signal, that is the cos signal. Cos 2 pi ft signal. Here display the calculated power of the, for this cos signal. Now we have to display the our calculated power of the signal. For that power, what is the formula? Sum of absolute value of x of square, that means summation of mod of x whole square by length of the particular x, length of x. Now plot t comma x, plot of t comma x. Now we are plotting this t with respect to x. MATLAB mtlb underscore axis, that is x axis is from 0 to 0.1 and y axis is from 0 to 1. Display the theoretical, that is the power of the signal. Then run and save the signal. This is our output of power signal. Output of power signal. Okay. With this energy, how we are writing the program for energy signal and how we are writing the program for power signal is completed.